Hi, welcome to automation testing.in. In this video we will see capturing full page screenshot in Protractor. So when there is a failure, then you need to capture a screenshot for that particular failure, where and in which page the script got failed. So for that you want to take that particular page screenshot and you want to store somewhere and you want to see. But here we'll see how to capture that full page screenshot in Protractor. So for that, go to Visual Studio. Here I'll create a file under the specs folder, full page screenshot demo.js. okay, I'll simply copy some code from here to here. This is full page screenshot, and I'll say here how to take full page screenshot in Protractor. Okay, so now I'll remove this code, this is not needed here. So where I'll go here, demo.automationtesting.in/register.html. okay, here browser.driver.get. Here I'll take this one, register.html. Once I go there, I want to take screenshot. So for that we need to import some package in Protractor. So that is var fs is equals to, you need to mention require, in the bracket you need to mention fs. Okay, so this is file stream. You are importing or taking, what do you say, in Java you import some packages, right? In C sharp you using. So the same way here, here you use require. Require means it will give you this file stream package kind of. Okay, so that I'm storing in some variable. So here what we need to do, browser dot take screenshot is a method. Browser dot take screenshot is a method, so it will give you the promise. So you need to resolve by using then. So under then you'll say one more function, and I'm just giving some image or png, whatever it may be. Otherwise I'll take full page. Okay, so inside this what you need to do, where some variable, you are creating a variable fs dot create write stream. You see that read stream, write stream methods are coming from the fs. Okay, fs dot create write stream, where to write. Right, where to write means in which folder or which location you want to save that, and with which name. So what I'll do here in the Protractor tutorial, I'll create a folder. Folder name screenshots. I created screenshots. So under the screenshots, so dot means current directory. So under that screenshots slash full page dot png. I'm giving in this location with this name, full page dot png. And then you need to do stream dot write, stream dot write new buffer. Under the buffer you have two things here. One is in which format you want to store, which file you want to store. That is, we took full page read, comma, and using base 64 format. And then you need to mention stream dot end. Okay, this is the code you need to use to capture the screenshot. Okay, So first we need fs, and after that browser dot take screenshot. It is directly available in the protractor, browser dot take screenshot. Then this full page var stream equal to fs dot create write stream, and where you want to store in under which file name. So then stream dot write new buffer, and what is the name that full page, and you are using base64 format, and then stream dot end. When you're dealing with the files, you need to close that connection, then only there you'll not find any issues. Okay, so this is all about the taking screenshot. So now we'll see whether it is taking the screenshot or not by executing this. Sorry, we did not change in the com.js, right? com.js, we need to change full page screenshot demo. So I'll execute again and we'll see. So keep in that mind, we need to change the file name in com.js. Frequently we'll forget. So it went to the register.html page. So it's done. Now we'll open the screenshots. You see that full page.png came. When I click on this, you see that it is giving me the entire page, right? It is giving me the entire page. So this is how you can capture full page screenshot in Protractor. Okay, that's all in this video. Before concluding this video, I have a small request that please subscribe to my YouTube channel for further and interesting updates. Thank you.